morning students, today we are going to see a new lesson, multiple representation of data using the spreadsheet. From this lesson, you are going to learn how we can represent the data using the spreadsheet application. Okay, spreadsheet is nothing but that is a table which consists of many rows and columns. Generally, they are used to analyze the data, arrange the data, okay, and then we can also perform various calculations using the spreadsheet applications. Say suppose you want to find the total for all the students, okay, total marks for all the students in 6th standard, your quarterly marks total, then we can enter all your marks, okay, in each subject you have to be scoring marks, so we can enter all those marks in the spreadsheet application and then we can find total easily. And then we can also view that marks in the pictorial form, either as a chart or as a graph. Okay, this is the one of the main uses for using the spreadsheet application. And there are spreadsheet applications like LibreOffice Calc and MS Excel. In this lesson, we are going to see in detail how we are going to use the MS Excel application. The file extension for LibreOffice Calc is .ods and for MS Excel it is .xls. Okay, students, the data can be either a text, it can be a number, or it can be a formula. The marks we are entering, and we are also entering the subject name. No, so the data can be either the text, which is the subject name, the number, which is the marks we have scored in each subject, and the formula is nothing but it is the we are giving for total. No, for if you want to add all the columns, okay, all the rows, then we are giving some formula to add. No, so that is there we are entering the cell number, that is known as the formula. So these are the datas which we are giving in the spreadsheet application. Then we are going to see the uses of spreadsheet. Using spreadsheet, we can enter data, we can also edit the data. Once data is entered, we can also change it, okay, we cannot change the values. We can also format our data, okay. Formatting here refers to we can merge cells, okay, we can delete, okay, we can insert. So these are the some of the options for formatting our data. Then we can perform calculations or data. Calculations is, I already told, we can find the total, we can find percentage, we can find the average using our data. Then we can also view the pictorial representation of our data, that is we can either view as a chart or graph. Okay, everything we are going to see in detail in this lesson. Okay, then this this is the process to open the LibreOffice Calc. First you have to click the LibreOffice icon and then you have to select the Calc spreadsheet option. Then the spreadsheet will get opened using the LibreOffice Calc. Then we are going to see how we are going to open in Microsoft Excel. For that, first we have to click start and then click MS Excel option, or else we have to type MS Excel in the search, button near the start. Okay, you have to type MS Excel and then you can, if you click enter, then MS Excel application gets opened and then you have to select the option blank workbook. Okay, blank workbook you have to select and then your spreadsheet will get opened. Then we are going to see, okay, once you have opened any of the spreadsheet application, this will be your spreadsheet which you will get viewed. Okay, so from this we are going to see how we are going to use it. This is the close button. Okay, this closes the application and this closes the window. This one is used to maximize our application. This one is used to restore. Okay, then this is application minimize and this is also Windows minimize option. This is application minimize and this is Windows minimize, and this question mark is used for help. Okay, and this is the minimize ribbon icon. So this is the ribbon. Okay, we can minimize this using this arrow mark. And then this is the title bar. Okay, book 1 Microsoft Excel, this gives your title. Once you save this file, you can see the name which you have given. Okay, suppose you have given the quarterly marks for 6th standard, then the title appears here. Instead of book 1, the title which you are saving will get appears here. And this is the tab bar here, okay, file, home, insert, page, layout. Now these are the various tab. Okay, so this is the tab list. And then this is the quick access toolbar we are having. Okay, save icon. Okay, undo and redo. These are the quick access toolbar. And this gives the, this is the file button. And this is the name box. Okay, name box is nothing but, before going to name box, first you have to know what is meant by the row and the column. So this is the column. Okay, column is usually represented using the alphabets. Okay, there are so here you can see A, B, C, D. Okay, these are the columns. Columns are usually denoted using the alphabets, and there are columns starting from A to, okay, A to, it is from XFT. Okay, so totally there are 16,384 columns. Okay, so totally there are 16,384 columns starting from A to XFT. Here starting from A till XFT, okay, till XFT column is there. Totally there are 16,384 columns. Then these are the rows. Rows are represented using the numbers. Okay, rows are represented using the numbers, and there are totally 1,048,576 rows are there. Okay, totally there are 1,048,576 rows are there in an Excel application. Okay, now we can see what is meant by the name box. Name box is nothing but the address. Okay, cell address. Cell address is this is called as the cell. So intersection of a row and a column. So this is the intersection of a row and a column, and it is called as a cell. So this is called as a cell. This is called as a cell. Okay. So the cell is usually denoted. Okay. It is usually identified. Okay. The cell வந்து எப்படி identify பண்ணுவோம், ஒரு particular cell environment எப்படி identify பண்ணுவோம் அப்படின்னா, அதோட செல் நம்பர் வச்சு, செல் அட்ரஸ். ஓகே, செல் அட்ரஸ் வச்சு நம்ம ஐடென்டிஃபை பண்ணுவோம். ஸோ செல் அட்ரஸ்ங்கிறது இதுதான். ஓகே, திஸ் இஸ் நோன் அஸ் த செல் அட்ரஸ். செல் அட்ரஸ் ஃபர்ஸ்ட் வந்து யூஸ்வலா என்ன இருக்கும் அப்படின்னா, காலமோட நம்பர். அப்போ இதுதான் நம்ம வந்து பாக்குறோம் அந்த பர்டிகுலர் செல். ஓகே, ஸோ இதுல ஃபர்ஸ்ட் காலம் நம்பர் என்ன? ஏ. அப்போ ஏ தான் ஃபர்ஸ்ட் இருக்கணும். ஓகே, செல் அட்ரஸ்ல. அடுத்து ரோ நம்பர். அடுத்து என்ன இருக்கணும்? ரோ நம்பர். ஸோ இங்க ரோ நம்பர் என்ன? 1 தானே ரோ நம்பர். ஸோ 1. ஸோ செல் அட்ரஸ்ங்கிறது ஃபர்ஸ்ட் வந்து காலம் நேம் இருக்கணும், ரெண்டாவது வந்து ரோ நம்பர் இருக்கணும். ஸோ திஸ் இஸ் நோன் அஸ் த செல் அட்ரஸ். ஓகே சில்ட்ரன். அண்ட் தென் திஸ் பிளாக், திஸ் கரண்ட் செல், ஓகே, விச் யூ ஆர் டைப்பிங், தட் வில் பி த ஆக்டிவ் செல். எந்த செல்ல வந்து இந்த பிளாக் கலர், ஓகே, மார்க்கிங் ஒரு ஹைலைட்டர் இருக்கோ, அதுதான் வந்து ஆக்டிவ் செல் சொல்லுவோம். ஓகே, அங்கதான் அந்த செல் வந்து ஆக்டிவா இருக்கு. தென் யூ கேன் சிம்பிளி டைப் த டேட்டா இன்டூ இட் ஜஸ்ட் பை கிளிக்கிங். யூ கேன் டிராக் யுவர் மவுஸ், யூ கேன் கிளிக் தேர், அண்ட் தென் யூ கேன் ஸ்டார்ட் டைப்பிங். ஓகே, ஓகே சில்ட்ரன். ஸோ நவ் யூ, ஐ ஹோப் யூ அண்டர்ஸ்டாண்ட், ஓகே, அபவுட் த ரோஸ், காலம்ஸ் அண்ட் த செல், செல் அட்ரஸ், எவ்ரி திங். ஓகே, தென் வி ஆர் கோயிங் டு சி, திஸ் இஸ் த expand formula bar button. So this is the formula bar. Okay, whatever you have typed will appear here. The formulas whichever you have typed will get appear here. We can see it later, okay, how it appears. And then this is the zoom control option. You can either see if you are keep on typing, you want to enter more data, okay, from A it's going on, then you can zoom and zoom in and zoom out to view the data using this button. And then this is the vertical scroll bar. You can go, you can scroll down easily using this vertical scroll bar. And this is the status bar, okay. And this is the horizontal scroll bar. You can, so this is the vertical and this is the horizontal scroll bar. Using this you can move left to right, and using this you can move from top to bottom. Okay, so this is the formula bar, and I already told you this is the ribbon. Okay, here you can also paste and the various option for the font size, style, bold, italic, everything is here, and here the alignment options. Okay, these are similar to Word only. Okay, then this is the worksheet, insert worksheet button. So normally this is known as the worksheet. First you have to know the difference between the worksheet and the workbook. Okay, so worksheet is nothing but the sheet. Okay, normally we are using, usually when you open an Excel application, it automatically opens as sheet 1 only. Okay, sheet 1, sheet 2, sheet 3 will be there. We can also add extra sheets using this insert worksheet button. Once you click this, and sheet number 4 will get added. Okay, workbook is nothing but they are the collection of the worksheets. Okay, that if there are many worksheets, okay, then we call it as an workbook. Okay, you can save it. If you are usually we use only a single sheet. Suppose we want to use sheet 2, sheet 3, sheet 4, okay, etc. If you are using, okay, and then we are saving it, then that is known as the workbook. Okay, it consists of many sheets. You are using many sheets into it. So that is the difference between the worksheet and the workbook. And as I told you, this is the active cell indicator where that black mark is there. No, that is the active cell indicator. It's always gets highlighted. Okay, then this is the sheet tab scroll button, which is used to scroll between the various sheets. You can switch on, okay, two different sheets using this sheet tab scroll button. You can switch on to sheet 2, sheet 3 using these buttons. Okay, now we are, I hope you are clear with the Excel screen. And now we are going to see how to calculate the sum total average for your mark list. Okay, I am going to teach you how we can see it. Okay, children. Now we have opened the MS Excel application. Okay, first we are going to see. Okay, this is the book one title. I told you already, it will default, it will give you book one. We can change it. First we are going to save the file. Okay, just click the save icon, and then you are going to give a name. Okay, I'm going to give us mark list. Okay, this is the extension. .xls is the extension for the MS Excel application, and then you are going to click the save, and it gets, the book one gets changed to the given name. Okay, then we are going to see. So this is the active cell. No, these are the different cells. Okay, this is the active cell is usually highlighted using this black mark. So this is the active cell. Now we have clicked here, it have changed. So this, now this is the active cell. B1 is the active cell. So it gets displayed. No, the cell address. First there will be the column number and column name, and then will be the row number. So this is the active cell. And I told you, no, this is the worksheet. Already it's opened as sheet 1. You can add some worksheet, extra worksheet using this icon. So sheet 2, sheet 3 we can add. Okay, so now we are going to see from sheet 1. First I'm going to type the mark list name. Okay, say for example, we are going to type Sheila third semester mark sheet. Okay, third term mark list. Okay, and see here. So this is the heading, Sheila third term mark list. We are going to see, okay, what she scored in her third term. Okay, then see from A to C. So from here to there it's going, no, within A it is not that. From it's going to B1 and it's going to C1 also. So how we can merge these cells? Okay, the moon cell you know, every one the ore cell on the merge pandra. So that we are going to see now. First we have to select the cells, okay, which we want to merge and center. We have to select the cells, and then we have to click the merge and center icon. Okay, once you click, see now it gets merged. Now in between there is no line. Okay, but before that we are seeing that it is separated by using the lines. Okay, now there is no line, so single it is represented. Okay, ipo pathina theriyum inge vande தனித்தனியா தெரியுது. ஓகேவா, உங்களுக்கு ஆக்டிவ் செல் வந்து தனித்தனியா தெரியுது. பட் நான் இங்க வந்து நம்ம சென்டர் பண்ணதுனால, மர்ஜ் பண்ணதுனால நமக்கு வந்து இது வந்து ஒரு சிங்கிள் செல்லா தான் தெரியும். ஓகேவா, சோ நீங்க வந்து இந்த மர்ஜ் அண்ட் சென்டர் ஐகான் யூஸ் பண்ணலாம், இல்லைன்னா நீங்க வந்து ரைட் கிளிக் பண்ணி, ஓகே, யூ கேன் கிளிக் கோ டு த ஃபார்மேட் செல்ஸ் ஆப்ஷன். ஓகே, தேர் இன் அலைன்மெண்ட். ஓகே, ஃபார்மேட் செல்ஸ் கிளிக் பண்ணிட்டு அலைன்மெண்ட்ல நீங்க வந்து மர்ஜ் செல்ஸ் வந்து நீங்க கொடுக்கலாம். ஓகே, இது நீங்க வந்து டிக் பண்ணீங்கன்னா, செக் பாக்ஸ் டிக் பண்ணிட்டு ஓகே கொடுத்தீங்கன்னா மர்ஜ், அந்த செல்ஸ் வந்து மர்ஜ் ஆயிடும். ஸோ ஆல்ரெடி நம்ம வந்து இப்போ வந்து இதை வந்து மர்ஜ் பண்ணிட்டோம் இல்லையா, அதனால மர்ஜ் செல்ஸ் ஆப்ஷன் வந்து டிக்ல காமிக்குது. ஸோ இப்போ நான் இதை வந்து அன்டிக் பண்றேன். ஓகே, அன்டிக் பண்ணிட்டு ஓகே கொடுக்குறேன். சி நவ் இட் இஸ் அப்பியர்ட் அஸ் எ சிங்கிள் செல் ஒன்லி. ஓகே, ஸோ அகெயின் ஐ எம் கோயிங் டு ரைட் கிளிக் இட், ஐ எம் கோயிங் டு ஃபார்மட் செல்ஸ் அண்ட் தென் ஐ எம் டிக்கிங் செக்கிங் த செக் பாக்ஸ் மர்ஜ் செல்ஸ் அண்ட் ஐம் கிளிக்கிங் ஓகே. சி நவ் யூ சி நவ் த செல்ஸ் கெட் மர்ஜ். ஓகே, this is how we can merge the cells. Okay, you can either click this merge and center icon or else you can right click it, go to format cells and then you can click alignment and then you can merge and center, then you have to click okay. Okay, now we are going to type the marks for the Sheena. So first we are going to type the subject name. Okay, subject name. Okay, to switch between the cells you can use either the tab key, okay, tab key in your keyboard, or else you can use the right arrow or left arrow to switch between the cells. I have typed the subject, okay, and then I am switching to another cell using the tab key. Okay, so this is the active cell. I am switching to the other cell using the tab key and then I am typing the marks. Okay, whatever you type here it gets appeared here. Okay, so the marks I have typed and then I am moving on to the other cell and I am typing the subject name. Okay, say for example English. Okay, and then I am pressing the down arrow and then I am typing Tamil, then maths. Okay, then social, then science, finally computer. Okay, see here it is up to the edge now. So computer, we can also expand this cell. Okay, just by clicking here you can the width changes. Okay, just you can move it. Okay, now it's okay. No, okay, then we are going to type the mark for e subject. Okay, okay, she scored some 98 in English and 67 78, social 90 and 93 in science, okay, 84 in computer. Okay, now we have typed her third term mark list and we are going to find the total. Okay, so I am going to type here total. Okay, and we are going to find the total for the marks which she scored. So we can do it in two ways. Okay, so first you are going to select the cells. Sorry. Okay, we are going to select the cells and then click this auto sum option. Okay, then the total automatically it gets appeared here. So first what I have did, okay, I will undo and I will show it to you. Okay, first I have selected the cells, okay, for which I need the total, that is the cell address from B3 to B8. Okay, I have selected and then I have clicked the auto sum icon. Okay, automatically it adds up all the total, okay, for the selected cells and then it displays. Okay, I have selected and then I have clicked auto sum option. Okay, then the total of the marks which she obtained gets appeared here, that is 510 appeared. Okay, okay, other way. Okay, just you can type the formula. Okay, for here. Okay, that is always the formula we have to type with the equal sign. Okay, so equal. Okay, any formula you have to start typing with the equal sign. Equal. Okay, sum. Okay, sum, and then we are going to give the cell address in the bracket, that is B3. Okay, B3, once you have given, the cell gets automatically, it gets selected. So B3, okay, colon up to B8 we want to add. No, so up to B8. Now once you have given this, see, it automatically the cell gets selected. Okay, and then we are closing it and then you have to click the enter key in your keyboard. Once you click enter, see, you get the total. So this is how we get total. Okay, here I have entered the mark list. Hey, you can get total for whatever datas. Okay, you can get the sum for whatever datas you enter into the spreadsheet. Now we are going to calculate the percentage. Okay, I'm going to type here percentage. We are going to calculate the percentage for her marks. Okay, it is coming very close. Again I am moving it. So now we are going to calculate the percentage. To calculate the percentage, first, always the formula starts with an equal to. You have to type the equal to sign. Then you have to give the cell address. No. So here I want the percentage for the total which she scored. So cell address here is B9. I'm going to type B9. Sorry. I'm going to type here B9. Okay. The other cell gets selected. Then I'm going to divide. For dividing, you have to use the backslash. Okay, divided by the total number, total marks. Okay, totally here 6 subjects, so 600. Okay, into 100. We are going to give into 100. Okay, so sorry, I have typed. We have to close it. Okay, so into 100. Just first we have to start typing with the equal to sign. Then you have to give the cell address B9. Then the cell gets selected. Then you have to divide that by 600. And then we have to close that. Okay, that is one process. And then we are again, we want to multiply it using the 100. After dividing by 600, and that answer should be get multiplied by 100 to get the percentage. Once you have typed the formula, then you can press the enter key. Okay, then the percentage which she scored gets appeared. So 85% she have scored out of 100. So this is how we can find the percentage. I have told you, know, we can also edit data using the spreadsheet applications. Now we are going to see how we can edit data. Okay, first see here, here we have calculated her total as well as her percentage. Okay, now say suppose I have entered her max mark wrongly. Instead of 87, I have entered as 78. Okay, or something. Instead of 90, I have entered as 78. Say like that. Okay, I am changing. Okay, I am changing it as 90. Okay, then okay, after automatically once you click enter, okay, then your total as well as your percentage gets changed. Okay, again we need not do the calculations again. We not give the formula, or again we not click that icon, okay, for some icon. Automatically when you edit the data, the calculations which you have made, it also gets edited. Okay, it's automatically it's get changed the value we enter. Okay, again, okay, say suppose again I'm entering it as 78. Okay, 78, and once I click enter, told, okay, the which we previously did, no, that total and that percentage appears. So we can edit data and automatically the calculations which we done, it also changes. Okay, it changes automatically. Now we have entered the marks. Okay, sum epdi total epdi kandikadum paathutom, percentage epdi kandikadum paathutom, data edit panna epdi values change aagum nu paathom. Next nama vandu pictorial representation epdi pandradhu nu paakapom. Idu epdi graph la represent pandradhendra nama paakapom. Okay, so first we have to go to insert. Okay, insert option, then we have to choose enna type of chart undu ungalku theva appdi choose pannom. So idhula vandu 2d 3d bar when eppadi ungaloda graph vandu eppadi irukano nu sonna nama choose pandrom. Okay, I have chosen this, then automatically the chart for the data it gets appeared. Okay, இதை நீங்கள் எங்கனாலும் மூவ் பண்ணி உங்களோட இதில் எங்கனாலும் மூவ் பண்ணி உங்களுக்கு எங்கே வேணுமோ அங்கே மூவ் பண்ணி வச்சுக்கலாம். ஓகே, யூசிங் த மவுஸ் வி கேன் ட்ராக் அண்ட் வி கேன் கீப் வேர் எவர் வி வாண்ட். ஓகே, ஸோ இதில் வந்து நம்ம அடுத்து டேட்டாஸ் எப்படி எடிட் பண்ணுறது அப்படின்னு நம்ம பார்க்க போகிறோம். ஸோ ஃபஸ்ட்டு டைட்டில், சார்ட் டைட்டில் நம்ம இதில் நீங்கள் வந்து சேஞ்ச் பண்ணிக்கலாம். ஓகே, சார்ட் டைட்டில் டிஃபால்ட்டாக இருக்கும். ஸோ இதை வந்து நீங்கள் தேர்ட் டேர்ம் mark list அப்படி நீங்க change பண்ணிக்கலாம். ஓகே, third term mark list, then you can also change the axis title. Okay, you can give here the title, you can change the title here. Okay, as you can give here as marks. Can give here as marks. So this is the marks, no? It's good. Can give us the marks. You can also, you can also change the axis title also. Okay. Axis title, Okay. Can gives the data label also. So the mark, no, it gets appeared, data table. So the values for the graph, it gets appeared. Okay. So this is the data table which gets represented in series. So axis title we have changed. Okay. We can also change the series also. Here also we can change. If there is more, if we are representing for more than one student, okay, then we can give the two students series also. We can change. So we are using only series one. Okay, it gets represented only a single data, and then we are using this option. We have changed the axis titles to marks. So this is the marks and this is the subject. We have changed the axis titles, and we can also change the style. Okay, which the chart want to appear, we can choose the different style, and then we can also choose the color, which color your bar want to appear. So now we have found how we can calculate the data and how we can represent it. Okay. So namma vandu ipo vandu or sheet na enna alle epdi marks enter pandrathu total percentage epdi kandupidikkudhu graph epdi represent pandrathu paathutom purinjirukku nenikiren. Thank you students.